Good morning, friends. Greetings from Ground Zero. It's the last of the cherry blossoms, although the ground is gorgeous with cherry blossom snow. Cherry blossom season is amazing. It's short, but it's worth the wait, and it was worth planting those trees 10 years ago. I don't have anything really awesome, happy, or inspirational, or wise, or anything to share today. I'm not gonna lie, I am not okay. I have been going through this alone, and I understand that having to homeschool and deal with your children 24/7 while you're trying to work or trying to deal with the realities of not having any money because you're not working, and being cooped up with spouses and partners 24/7 is hard. I get that, but it's an entirely different animal when you are wholly and completely alone. I can't remember the last time I touched another human being. We had our last dance performance on February 29th, so there was some hugging amongst the dance troupe and some other friends at the Washington Center for the Performing Arts. In an early March, I shook a second lieutenant's hand at work. And that's been it. I have not touched another human being. I have not been within, willingly, been within about 10 to 12 feet of another human being, and it's wearing on me. I'm vacillating back and forth between debilitating depression, just not even wanting to get up off the couch or out of bed in the morning, or extreme anxiety, and sometimes just rage. I've been wanting to get off social media because it's been frustrating me anyway, but it's literally my only communication with the outside world right now, so I'm having to be very careful what I read and where I go, but it's still a constant bombardment. And I directed some rage at somebody yesterday. I went for a walk, which has been really hard to get motivated to go out and do. And I met a friend in the open air at a park. It was her birthday week. She's been out of work. She was really stressed out and broke, single mom anyway. So I took her bag of birthday asparagus and we met at the park. We never got within 10 feet of each other. We were both wearing masks. I set the bag down and stepped away slowly, and I thought I would take a walk down on the waterfront. So wandered down the street, and there's a bridge, the Murray Morgan Bridge, or 11th Street Bridge for those who live in Tacoma. And there's a stairwell that goes down from downtown down to the Theophosse Waterway, which is a great super wide walkway to walk. That stairwell was being inhabited by a completely clueless, selfish, privileged woman who was running the stairwell. So I waited for her to come up. I went down. Then she turned around and came behind me. She was within like a foot of me, breathing hard on me, not wearing a mask. So I thought, on one of the landings, I just pulled over and I said, "Would you please, I'm going to let you go. Would you please stay away from me?" So she went down. She came back up, got right in my face coming back up, and I said, "Would you please stay away from me?" Passes me again on a landing within about a foot and a half, 2 feet, breathing hard, totally clueless, actually thinking it's really amusing. So I get to the bottom of the stairwell, and I am maybe 4 steps from being out of the stairwell, and the bitch comes right at me, like a foot and a half from my face, breathing hard, because she couldn't wait long enough for me to take the last 4 fucking steps to get off the stairwell. And that's when my requests became less polite. And I said, "Stay the fuck away from me. What in the fuck is wrong with you?" I used some very aggressive body language. Of course, I would not be stupid enough to intentionally get close to somebody. And I would never be dumb enough to physically assault somebody because I like my job. And that's not the kind of person I am. But I think I might have scared her a little bit. And I'm proud of myself for not ending that sentence with the word bitch, which is exactly what I was thinking. So it was not a very relaxing walk once I got down along the Theophosse Waterway. People were wearing masks. If they weren't, they were staying 10, 12, 20 feet away from people. I had my mask. If I saw another person, I pulled it up. But I think I'm just going to have to stick to walking in my neighborhood because I don't live in a privileged neighborhood, and people are here are being a lot more considerate. And it's these inconsiderate assholes that are making this go on a lot longer than is necessary because they're assholes. And I've got nothing else. Yeah. I need to stop ranting now. But apparently, I needed to rant to somebody because I am still pissed, Steve. And I understand that I do have privilege to complain about living in my own house alone is privilege, but it's hard and I'm sad and I'm lonely and I can't remember the last time I touched another human being. And I don't know when I'll touch another human being again because I don't know when it'll be safe for them or for me. I guess that's it today. So for those of you that are navigating this alone, I want to say you're not alone, but you are alone. But there are a lot of us that are alone and we understand it. And we're with you. And I wish this had been something a little more positive and cheerful, but it's not today. I'm not doing well emotionally. This has been over 2 months for me, and I'm starting to break. And I'm gonna, in order to end this on a positive note, I'm gonna turn the camera, and I'm gonna show you my lilacs and my cherry blossoms now. Part of me wants to just delete this and not post it, but part of me knows that I can't possibly be the only person feeling like this. So even if I'm kind of making a fool of myself crying, I'm gonna share it because maybe it'll make somebody else feel less alone.
There are the lilacs.
And there's the cherry blossoms now. And that's gonna be it for me today. Maybe next time I do one of these, it won't be quite so depressing. Be kind to yourself, be kind to others, and just do the best you can.